All right, this is continuing the last video covering setting up an engine in KSP. This video is going to deal with using the newer effects nodes that was introduced, I think, back in 0.23. Turn these off for now. We will okay, that's a better example. Okay, there we go. So I've changed around the Unity setup a little, arrangement a little bit, so you can better see the effects based on the changes that I'm making in the KSP particle emitter script. But first, I'm gonna go through the effects node definition and the config. And then we'll come back and jump back and forth between the config and the Unity setup so you can kind of see the connection a little bit better, hopefully. So if you're going to use the newer effects node, it looks like this. Effects curly bracket in all caps. And then inside you define your engine state blocks. Right, that's the same as the older method where you define the running state, the power state, the disengage, flame out, engage engine states. And then inside of each engine state you have your particle blocks and your audio blocks. So here's an audio block, right? And for audio block you have volume and pitch inputs. These are based on your throttle setting. So at zero throttle, the volume would be zero. At full throttle, it would be one. And the second number is a multiplier on your sound clip. So, if your sound clip had a volume of X, this would be, same as X, or doubled or tripled or whatever fraction or decimal point you have set here. Same goes for pitch, right? Except it changes the pitch up and down. Loop true or not, if it's a one shot effects like for engage or flame out, then you set that to false. It's going to play that sound clip once and not play it again. If it's loop, then it's engine effects, and just keep playing it over and over based on the input curves from your throttle setting. And then there are two types of particle blocks. So one is a prefab particle. That's the old effects that you would see in an older engine config. Smoke trail light, smoke exhaust, blue, medium, or whatever. If you're using you first name the prefab particle name, right? If it's a prefab particle, then you use this you use this prefab underscore particle to define this block, and then you have the name. That's the particle that you want to use for this block, and then transform is the transform in your engine that you want to assign this particle to. The one thing you have to watch out for with the prefab smoke trails is that they're configured to emit in the negative y direction. So if you set it to your thrust transform, the smoke is going to come out the side instead of out the nozzle as you would expect. So That's why on the engine, there's an extra transform called smoke point. It doesn't have to be called smoke point. It's just a convention. You can call it whatever you want. And that's set up so that the Y is pointing up, so the smoke trail will emit in the correct direction. Back to our config. Emission is, again, a multiplier on the emission rate of your particle. We'll cover that in a second. Speed, again, same thing, a multiplier on the velocity of the particle. And then it's local position, right? This replaces the FX offset setting in the old module engines, and this tells KSP where to specifically place the particle emitter in relation to the transform you named up here. So if you want to shift this to the right or left or up and down, then you change the settings. So for example, if I wanted to move this rocket flame away from the thrust transform, away from the nozzle, I would increase the Z value, because the thrust transform, the Z is pointed out from the nozzle. If I wanted to move it closer to the nozzle, then I would set the Z value to a negative number. There's one more setting here, and that's energy, and that's the duration of a particle, the lifespan for a particle that's emitted, and that's in seconds. At zero throttle, the energy will be zero. At full throttle, the energy would be one. This is a multiplier, so whatever your setting in the particle is, it's going to multiply this number. There are default values for these. So it looks like the default is 1. So if you don't define it, then it's going to use whatever settings you have here and not change it inside of KSP based on your config settings. So this config gives you an extra layer of control to get the exact particle effects you want. Audio, you can have multiple audio blocks in each state. So here, there's another prefab particle block. And then for the engine module, everything else works the same way. It doesn't affect module jettison or animate heat or module gimbal. The only difference in your config, besides the new block, particle and audio definitions, is the module engines. You have to use module engine effects. Again, the rest of the setting is pretty much the same as the standard module engines. Define your curves, your ISP and velocity curves, propellants, all the same exact way. Module engines effects have a few extra settings that deal specifically with the engine states. That's right here: flame out, running, power, engage and disengage. Direct throttle name, I don't really see a difference using that or not. It looking at the code, it has something to do with requested throttle versus actual throttle setting. So it might have something to do with atmospheric engines, where the engine could set the engine to full throttle, but the engine isn't running at full throttle because of lower intake air supply. Anyway, I'm just guessing there. I don't know exactly what this does, since I can't really see a difference. Also, you can look at the tutorial on the first page here. It explains some of the KSP particle emitter settings. That's the Hot Rockets particle effects mod on the forums. So that pretty much covers everything in the engine config side. So you got your audio block, your prefab particle block, your custom particle block, right? That's defined by model multi-particle. You can use multiple custom particles in an engine, as many as you want, really, whatever your system allows for. You have to make sure each multi-particle block has a unique name, and other than that, you know, you can use the same effects multiple times if you want to get a more visible effects. So yeah, that covers the config side. Well, let's jump over into the particle emitter. So start at the top. You create an empty game object, and then you add the KSP particle emitter script, and you'll get all the settings. But it's basically a script that pulls together relevant settings from the legacy particle system from Unity 3. Because you can see in this particle I made before, it adds these Unity components, and then these values are pulled into this one script component up here. So you don't have to deal with manually set up these multiple particle components, because these could be a little bit more confusing. I mean, this is pretty confusing as it is if you don't know what you're doing. Having to deal with more than one could get much worse. Alright, so emit, that turns the particle on and off. If you have this off, then nothing's going to happen in the game. So you want to make sure this is checked before you export your particle model. And to export it, it works the same way as exporting a part. You know, you put your part tool script, you set your directory, you set your texture format, and you hit write. And it comes out as a MU file, just like any other part. And then in the config, you point the model name to the path of the particle effects you exported. Simulate world space. This makes it so that once the particle is emitted, it is translated into world space instead of the engine's local space. So this is a quick, easy way to see this is world space, right? So if your engine's flying around, the trail is going to curve as you turn your ship. And then this is local space, right? This is like your standard rocket flame. It stays with the engine and doesn't curve or flow through the atmosphere. So if you're doing a smoke trail, then you want to use World Space. If you're doing your basic engine exhaust flame, then you want to do, you want to turn off World Space. Because there's a limit on how quickly the particles get emitted because of the physics update in Unity. If you, you know, have World Space on and you're moving at, you know, 500 meters per second, you're, the particle is just going to look like a series of dots, and it's not going to look very good. So next one, material. You assign a material. If you don't assign one, it's just going to look purple. That's the standard Unity thing to let you know, hey, you're missing something here. For material, you want to use the KSP particle shader additive if you're doing something that's like a flame that emits light. I mean, it's not going to emit light like a light object, but it's going to look like it's glowing. If you're doing smoke trail, then you want to use alpha blended. This is one of the places where you can't substitute a Unity particle effects. You know, whereas some of the other shaders, you can substitute a Unity standard shader, and sometimes it'll still work in KSP. If you, you know, try using a Unity particle, then it's just going to look odd in KSP, and it doesn't look right. So make sure you're using one of these two particle shaders for your custom effects. And then the texture could be anything you want. You know, you could have alpha channel. You could have, you know, you could have a, where's my preview window? Inspector. So you could have, you know, if you're using additive, then you can have a grayscale, or why's my, oops. You could have a grayscale, you could have a plain solid color texture with an alpha map, or you could have, you know, there's a lot of different ways of, a lot of different textures you could use. You know, like this is just a plain black, right? Black is not going to change anything on your screen, and then white is going to replace it. So the, right, this, I'm just going through a few different maps to show you what it looks like as a particle. Again, it uses the So it's using the grayscale value of your texture, whether it's a color texture or black and white texture, it doesn't matter, because all your colors, they're still a value, whatever your, you know, RGB setup is. So here we go. So assign your texture, and then size is, you know, the particle range, the size, the upper and lower range. You know, there's five. Yeah, this is in Unity, same units in Unity and KSP. So for like this 1.25 meter engine, you know, the maximum size, you know, you want it just a little bit below your exhaust nozzle size. So it's good to have your engine and have your particle emitter lined up so you can kind of get a good preview of what it looks like. And then energy, that's your lifespan of the particle, right? So if I turn this on, so this particle is going to exist anywhere between 0.1 to 10 seconds, which is a really, really long time. If you're doing smoke trail, then you want a long lifespan for your particles. If you're doing just exhaust flames, then you want a short life cycle. Again, this life cycle plays together with your exhaust velocity as well. So if you have a very high exhaust velocity, it's going to throw your particle much further out in the same lifespan as if you have a lower exhaust velocity. And the emission, this is your upper and lower bounds for the number of particles per each, whatever time unit the particle system updates on. Whether I don't know if it's standard update or fixed update or late update or what. But again, you know, there's a limit on how quickly the particle gets updated. So, you know, if you're traveling too quickly, too fast, and you have world space on, you're going to get a series of dots instead of a continuous stream. So that's something to keep in mind. Doing engines, you don't want to use the world velocity. You want to use the local velocity. That's going to be local to your thrust transform or whatever transform you assign this particle to. And random velocity gives a additional speed on the particle when it's emitted. So, you know, if you want it to spread out, you can give it a random velocity in the X and Y. If you want a tight stream, then you set these to zero. Right, you can have something that's more sporadic, then you give, or you could do this. So this is this at a certain point, this would counteract the exhaust velocity completely, so you get some particles that stay right where the exhaust is and some particles that travel further out. All right, and then force, these operate a little bit different. The force is applied to the particle after it's emitted, right? Whereas velocity is the speed and direction of the particle when it's emitted. Force is applied to the particle after it's emitted. So as a quick example here, you can see how it's different, right? The force, there's zero force on the particle. Well, there's force on the particle when it's emitted, but it takes time for that force to move the particle, right? So when the particles are first emitted, it doesn't get displaced by this force. And then as the particle travels along, the force has time to act on the particle and the particle gets pushed around based on the settings you have, right? So using force and random velocity, you can get different looks. Right, you can make this. So if this was going to be some kind of a smoke trail that, you know, slows down as it travels through the atmosphere, then you can apply a negative force that pushes back against the exhaust nozzle. Right? Oops. No, come on. There we go. So right? So now it's like there's a wind blowing into the exhaust and it's pushing the particles backwards. So the random force, you know, it acts in a random direction, I guess a random amount in the direction you set, whereas force, it's constant amount in the direction. So all your particles are going to get pushed in the positive x direction. So the random force spreads the particle in the x plane, right? Like this. So that's random force. So I guess it's a range between negative and positive 100 in this instance. And if we use normal force, then everything gets shifted in the same direction. Damping, that's a multiplier on the force. So a high number is going to speed up your particle. A lower number is going to slow your particle down. And if you set it to zero, then it's going to stop the particle altogether. All right, so there's point one. Point one, there's one, so there's no change here. And all right, next part, random rotation. All right, that's no rotation. Then this way the particles are, oops, didn't turn off. If you turn off rotation, then the particles are always a billboard and it always points to the camera that you're looking through. Right, and then if you put a random rotation on, then the particle gets spun in different directions. So, interesting. So there's what world access does. So playing with these effects, you can, you know, make some very interesting looking things. Actually, I should play with this a lot more. So there's the Z doesn't seem to do a whole lot. Okay, what about X? There's X. Pretty cool. So this is, you know, one of the things in KSP where you have a lot of room to be creative and do crazy things. So that's your rotation, whether it's local or world axis. Angular velocity is just how fast your particle is going to spin. Not much of a difference there, but so you can see there's a spin on the particle there. And if you set this to zero, then the particles are staying in the same orientation. So I guess this is in I don't know what unit this would be in. I mean, it looks like degrees. But it's kind of hard to tell. Anyway, it's something you can mess with on your own time. Animate color. That cycles the particle through these five colors over its lifespan. And so you can, you know, change these, change the alpha on each band. And it's nice that, you know, you can get a good preview of what the particle will look like inside of Unity, instead of having to reload the database every time you make a change in here. So that's what Animate Color does. If you turn it off, then you just have one color. Of course, you set it to black, then it's off. Well, that's assuming you're using additive. Let's see what it looks like with Alpha Blend. Okay, so, you know, Alpha Blend, we can have exhaust smoke going on. So if your engine's running super rich, you might get something like this. So this is what Alpha Blend looks like. Let's see. Additive, set this back to additive. Oops, there we go. And these, if you're doing a smoke trail, I think you can turn these on so the smoke trail will leave a shadow in the scene. I haven't really played with these settings, so I don't know exactly what they would look like in game. And I don't know what the performance cost of this stuff is. I imagine it would be a pretty hefty cost, you know, especially if you have the number of particles turned up pretty high. So yeah, that's pretty much all you need to know for using custom particles on your engine. So just to recap, you need your effects block, right? And then inside the effects, you have your engine state blocks: running, power, disengage, engage, flame out. And then inside of the engine state blocks, you have your audio block, you have your prefab particle block, and you have your custom particle block, multi-particle. You can, you know, double up, triple up on the blocks if you want to. And, you know, if you're doubling up on, if you're using multiple custom particle blocks, make sure your name is unique so they don't overlap. If you have two identical names, I think only one of them gets used. I don't think it breaks the game, but it just won't look like what you would expect. And then local position shifts the particle effects around the transform you attach it to. Emission, that's a multiplier based on the throttle. Speed, that's a multiplier. So emission is a multiplier on your emission here based on your engine throttle. Speed is a multiplier of your velocity based on the engine multiplier. And energy is multiplier on your particle energy, your lifespan of your particle, based on the engine throttle. So yeah, that's everything you need to know for setting up custom particles and using them in your engine. Right, remember to use module engine effects. If you're using prefab smoke trails, then you know, have an extra transform that's oriented correctly. Y up. Your thrust transform is Z down or Z out from the nozzle. And let's see what else. Right, and one last thing is each particle model you export can only have one emitter. If you have more than one in the particle you export, in the particle custom particle you export, things are going to get weird in KSP. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. And now just to test out the settings. See if it works. There we go.